this is the second part of voting app, okay? And in this part, we will learn how we can do the block code. So first of all, let's go to the block here, okay? First, we need to fetch the information. So when we will fetch, whenever someone open our app, okay? So click on the screen and you will see the when screen will initialize, okay? So when the screen will initialize, we need to fetch the data. So first of all, we need to store the data here, right? So let me just store. First of all, you can do one thing. You can create an app here and you can create a database, or there's one more easy way to create it, okay? So let me just show you the easy way. So go to MIT App Inventor, just call it the Firebase, and you can see the store value like this. And for the tag, I'm gonna use your one tag is like, you know, that first tag is the person name, pname one, like this tag. And value we need to store, we can store the pname one is the null value. And again, I'm gonna just call one more is like pname two. Okay, this is the person name too. Now let me just run this app. Simply just run it, okay? AI companion, or I'm gonna use here, and I'm gonna use my phone here. Once the screen will initialize, then that Firebase store the value in this app, okay? So let's wait some seconds. So we don't need to worry about, you know, app name or something, you know. Let's go to here. You can see automatically the app is created, and you can see the name one and name two is also created. Now we can work further. Like we have just created person name, person two. The person name I'm gonna put here, like suppose Kamala Harris. Make sure wherever you put the name, you need to put quotation like this. Okay, so double, and under this, you just need to say here the Kamala Harris like this. And another name you can just put here, the Donald Trump, right? Now we have person one name, person two name. Now let's click on that plus icon. And is like p image one, okay? And the value, just double quotation, and just put anything like img and enter. Person one image, so we need to find the image person one. So suppose the person one image is like, you know, Kamala Harris. So Kamala Harris, and just use the Wikipedia here, okay? Here, click on that image, open image and new tab, and you see the .jpg URL. Go to the Firebase, go to here, and double quotation, and the double quotation, we need to put the URL like this. Now we need to just again add one more, like p image two. This is the person two image. Now I need to put the, you know, Donald Trump image. So like this one, I'm gonna go here, right click, open image in new tab, and just copy this image, go to the Firebase. It's really simple, and make sure double quotation is really important, okay? And just put it and tell it. You can see we have the two person image, their image also. Now we need to add the one more variable for the voting. So vote person one, and the value is zero for now. And again, vote two, and the person value is like the value is zero again. Done. So now we have the, you know, this thing, the total variable is six. Person one image, image two, person one name, name two, vote one, vote two. Done. Now let's go to the MIT App Inventor. Make sure don't call this again. Just delete it. Click this. Done. Now what we need to do here, we need to fetch the data. Okay. So this is important. So we need to call the list of all tags. Okay. So let me just click on the Firebase, and you can see the get tag list. This one. Call it here. Like this. Okay. Now, once we get the all tags from this Firebase, it means all the values. So we need to assign all these values in these variables. Like we need to assign the image one value, image two value, right? Okay. And the name also. So how we can do this? So we need to check the variables and then the value. So for that, I'm going to use here, click on Firebase. You can see once we got the tag list. Okay. So once we have a list, so we need to use here a for each loop. Van the Firebase dot tag list. Okay. So I'm going to use the for each loop. So to fetch the all the list one by one. Okay, this is the list. So this value is the list like this. Okay, Firebase again. And you can see the get value, this one. And then what we're getting, the tag is the item like this. Now, once we get the value, suppose we fetch the P1 image. Okay, because it's a loop. Okay, so first that will fetch the P image one. So once this at fetch p image one tag, it means this tag, it means we need to call here the got value, Firebase got value, this one. So once we got the value, so we need to check is that is really a same tag that we are fetching. So I'm going to use the control and use the if, use the logic like this. If that tag, okay, if that tag, okay, PMH is equal. Okay, so which one is equal? So we just need to check if that text, and we need to, we know that that PMH1. So I'm going to just type here PMH1 is equal that tag. Then we need to set that value to in this image, this image one. Okay, so go to the image one and set image or picture like this. And the picture is like the URL. So I'm going to use the text component like this. Oh, sorry. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to just get the value and add it here like this. Simple. Okay. Now the same thing we need to apply for the all tags, like if this, and again, I'm going to use again another tag. If the tag value is image2, okay, then we need to set that in the another image, image2, like this. Go to here, this is the image2. Yes, image2, go to the block. Now again, we need to just copy paste this, and we need to check the tag. So where is the tag? This one, pname1. Okay, this is the tag. So pname1. So if that is the name, okay, pname1, it means that is the person1. So it means the label 5, okay? So go to the block and you can see the label 5 dot this set. And we already have assigned the value as here, pname, Donald Trump, like this. You can change anything right here. You can add any other name also. So I'm going to add just text component. Sorry. So I just need to add the value. Simple here. Get value like this. Okay. The same thing I need to do it for the all. Okay. So it's just simply like, let's click on again like this. If the tag value is person name 2, then I need to just check the person name label 3 is the second one, person name. So this is the label 2. Sorry, let me just check again. Yeah, label 3, it's a label 3, sorry. Label 3 is the get value. Again, I need to check more. It's like visually I need to check. I need to check the votes also. Okay, so simply if the tag is like, you know, there is a vote 1. So suppose vote 1, okay, and vote 2 both here. Okay, so like this. So we need to set all these votes. Vote 1 is going to be set here, here. So label 2, or for this, label 4. Okay, so label 2 like this, and this is for label 4. Like this, simple. Now we need to update. We need to update that signed value to the Firebase also. So I'm going to create one variable that will store the actual real-time values for our votes, because the multiple people are doing the votes here. Okay, so I'm going to just set the variable vote1, and the assign, I'm going to assign the value to 0 here. And the same thing I'm going to just assign to another variable like vote2, and it's also 0. Now I need to, every time whenever we update the votes, we need to set the same value in the Firebase also. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just set first the set the value here. So set, whenever we the value calls, we need to set the get value like this here. And the same thing we need to do it here also. Okay, this is for the vote2. Okay, this is for vote1. Like this, simple. Now, whenever someone click on the button, so we need to send the, we need to increase the votes, and we need to send that value also to the Firebase. We need to store that, okay? So how can I do this? So it's really simple. Let's go to the design. And you can see this is the button 1. So once the people click on the button 1, so where is the button 1? Here, like this. So we need to increase the value of votes. Okay, so how we can do this? And let's click on the here, the Firebase. So I'm going to store the value first, this one. And in which tag I need to store the value? Vote1. Okay, so simply go to the text here, come to here. This is vote1. And value to store, which value I need to store? So I need to store that value. Okay, I'm adding this value because this is the variable value that will update. But I need to increase the, you know, votes every time. That means that should be like going to be a plus, okay, every time. So it's a simple formula. Go to the math and you can see this one. Call it here. Get the global value, and that will increase by 1. Simply like this. And the same thing, we need to do one more thing here. Every time once we increase the value, we need to set that value in the global variable also. Okay, like this here. So once we store the value, so we need to add that value in the global variable. Once the global variable updated, that value can reflect on the all the apps. Same thing we need to apply for the another button, and the another button name is called button 2. So the button 2 is like this, and the tag will be the vote 2, and that global variable vote 2, and vote 2 and set here the vote 2. Simple as that. Now, once we store the value, we need to fetch the value once the Firebase got updated. Okay, call the Firebase and you can see the data changed. So whenever the data change on the Firebase, we call the vote values, these values, okay? Because multiple people are voting. So every time that will, you know, that will update it. So every time once the Firebase data update, it means votes update, we need to fetch the current value. So once the data changed, so we need to get the value. And which tag we need to get? It's simple. It's like, it's a vote one, like this. And if there's no value, then, okay, so I'm gonna just get it from like vote one variable. And the same thing I need to call it for the both, like vote two also. Simple as that. Now this is done. Now we need to check who is the winner here. Okay. So for that, I'm gonna use here the simple conditions, really very basic. Whenever the data is changed, whenever the data got updated. So every time we have the, you know, vote one and vote two, both value. So I'm gonna use here the control if, like this. If the label, you can see that we have votes and votes is label 2 and the label 4, like this. So if the label 2, like you can just call it here, label 2 value, label 2 dot text value, like this one, is greater than, okay, is less than, is greater than label 1 value or label 4 value, then the first person is the winner, okay, here. So how we can display it? So it's simple, is like in the winner tab, you can see this is the image, okay? And I'm gonna just make it height should be like, you know, automatic like this. And this is the image 3, okay? So in the image 3 is like, image 3 is here, this one, set image picture. And this will get that picture from where? If this is the person first, it means we can fetch it image 1, image dot picture, like this. The same thing I'm gonna do this one, like, so as if the this one, if the label 2 is less than, okay, by label 4, then who is the winner? It's like image picture 4, like this one image, this here. This image is this image is 2. So picture image 2 and picture image 3, that will set the image 2. That's it. Now if there is nothing, okay, there is no one is you know, is condition is true, it means they are equal, then how we can set it? It's simple. We need to set one that picture with any image you can set. So I'm gonna just set here one text box, and I'm gonna use it this. I'm gonna use the pixel way. Okay, this is the neutral something I'm gonna use here. Okay, this is the neutral one. What I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna use this picture. So right click on that picture, open image in new tab. You can see that is the URL of image. Go to the MIT App Inventor and paste it here. That's it. So that's really amazing. Let's try to run this. Okay, you can see we have 00 votes right now. So let's click on the vote for this. Comparis. Oh, there's one. Winner is one. Like this. Can see. Now you can increase the votes count like this. Now if you want to change the person, okay, and if you want to change and reset all that you know, campaign, how you can do this? It's really simple. Go to your app and you can see the all values. You need to change the images here. You need to change the picture to image. You can change the name. So let me just try this. Okay, so you can see the values here. Now let me just try to change it from the Firebase. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna just find someone else, says like Sabrina Carpenter. Here we are, and here's the you know, Wikipedia, and just right click on the image, open image in new tab like this. Okay, now copy that image. Oh, it's really very blur. Okay, so I'm gonna use this one picture, open image in new tab, and it's fine. Okay, here, and I'm gonna go to the Firebase, and for the image one, I'm gonna use here the this one. Okay, And for this one, I'm gonna just make sure this is really important. As you can see here, there's nothing changed right now here. I'm gonna refresh this app, or whenever people will open this app, they will see. So I can see there's nothing image. The reason is, I'm gonna show you, it's really important that whenever you paste that URL, make sure you need to use the double quotation. And then under this, you need to paste it. It means there will be a double quotation automatically like this. You can see the multiple double. So in the string, you need to use a double, and in the number, you don't need to use anything. You just need to enter the number and enter. And you can see the image here will be here. Let's refresh this. Whenever someone open app, the screen will initialize and the image will look like this, right? So you can change the name here also like this from here. Like, you know, Sabrina, like this. For the neural prompt, you can just change the name to, you know, Ellie. Let's try to open a refresh our app here from like this and try this. Oh, Sabrina and Ellie. That's really, you know, there's nowhere. So this is really a voting app you can create using the MIT App Inventor dynamic voting app. If you have any doubt, you can ask me on comment. Thank you so much for watching this series on a voting app. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.